Hi guys, warm welcome you all in today's video of English Literature. We are here going to discuss an important facts related to the life and literary career of Geoffrey Chaucer. Yes friends, who is known as the father of English literature in history of English literature. Yes, jinhe hum English literature ke father ke roop mein jante hain. We will discuss kuch unke related life se related facts and kuch unke literary career se related facts aaj is video mein hum डिस्कस करने वाले हैं अबाउट जियोफ्री चौसर. एंड यस फ्रेंड्स, अगर आप वीडियोस के पीडीएफ चाहते हो प्लीज ज्वाइन द मेंबरशिप ऑफ दिस चैनल ऑफ इंग्लिश जोन. आपको लिंक डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स में मिल जाएगा, वहां से आप चेक करके देख सकते हो कि उसके क्या टर्म्स एंड कंडीशंस हैं, क्या चार्जेस हैं आपको पे करने हैं. वाइल आफ्टर ज्वाइनिंग मेंबरशिप ऑफ दिस चैनल आपको पीडीएफ अवेलेबल होंगे, उसमें दो तीन आपके सेक्शंस अवेलेबल हैं जिनको आप चेक करके अपने कन्वीनियंट के अकॉर्डिंग मेंबरशिप ज्वाइन कर सकते हो. एंड यस फ्रेंड्स, ये बात रही मेंबरशिप की. अब हम बात करते हैं अबाउट की फैक्ट्स अबाउट जियोफ्री चौसर. लेट्स बिगिन दैट. हियर वी हैव द इंटरेस्टिंग फैक्ट्स अबाउट जियोफ्री चौसर. एंड द फर्स्ट पॉइंट वी हैव, जियोफ्री चौसर वॉज बॉर्न इन 1340 एंड डाइड इन 1400. वॉज एन इंग्लिश पोएट, ऑथर, डिप्लोमैट एंड कोर्टियर. यस फ्रेंड्स, जियोफ्री चौसर वॉज द poet, was the man who, this was the time duration from 1340 to 1400. He lived during this time. Uno 14th century mein unka janm hua tha and 1340 se lekar ke 1400 ka jo time duration hai ye Geoffrey Chaucer ka time duration hai. And Geoffrey Chaucer jab as a poet wo apne poetry compose karte the, that age was also known as the age of Chaucer, age of Geoffrey Chaucer. Geoffrey Chaucer ke age ke name se bhi jana jata tha. And he was English poet, courtier, author, diplomat, jo because he served English government also. Unhone English ruling period ko, English king ko bhi serve kiya hai. That's why he was also known as a diplomat. Next point we have, he was buried in Westminster Abbey. Yes friends, Westminster Abbey mein unhe dafnaya gaya tha. That was the place. And in that place, there was a specific place for poets. That is known as Poets Corner. Yes, वहाँ पे एक specific place था जहाँ पे poets को दफनाया जाता था. And he was the first poet to occupy a place. He was buried in that place. That was known as Poets Corner in Westminster Abbey. Next point we have, Chaucer was born in the reign of Edward III, lived through that of Richard II, and died the year after Henry IV ascended the throne. Yes, he was the person, he was the poet who lived during the time duration of three kings, ruling period of the three kings. He lived during that time. When he was born, at that time, Edward III was the king of England. And when he was living, means he was in his literary career, he started his literary career, and that time Richard II was the king. And when he died, Geoffrey Chaucer died, Henry IV ascended on the throne before 1 year of the death of Geoffrey Chaucer. Next point we have, he has been called the father of English literature and the father of English poetry. Yes friends, ye bahut hi important wo hai. उन्होंने कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन, बिकॉज ऑफ द कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ द हिस्ट्री ऑफ इंग्लिश लिटरेचर, वॉट ही हैज गिवन, वॉट ही हैज कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटेड टू इंग्लिश लिटरेचर, दैट्स वाई ही वॉज नोन एज द फादर ऑफ इंग्लिश लिटरेचर, बिकॉज ही वॉज द मैन, ही वॉज द पोएट हु हैड रिटन फर्स्ट टाइम इन इंग्लिश, इन मिडिल इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज. ही हैड कंपोज पोएम्स एंड ही वॉज ऑल्सो ब्रिलियंटली गिवन हिज पोएट्री, सच अ रिफाइंड थिंग, सच अ unified things. That's why he is known as the father of English poetry. Next we have, Chaucer has been hailed as the morning star of Renaissance. Yes friends, Chaucer ko morning star of Renaissance bhi bolte hain. This is also very important fact related to the literary career of the Geoffrey Chaucer. Now next, let's discuss some more important facts about Geoffrey Chaucer. Next important fact about Geoffrey Chaucer we have, Chaucer is known for metrical innovation, inventing the rhyme royal stanza consists of 7 lines each, and the rhyming scheme of that rhyme royal is A B A B B C C. This is the rhyming scheme which was invented by Geoffrey Chaucer, and which is known as the Rhyme Royal, and it has 7 lines in each stanza. Each stanza में 7 lines हुआ करती थी, and जो rhyming scheme होता था, that was AB, AB, B, C, C. And yes, friends, this was also one of the reason that's why he is known as the father of English literature and father of English poetry, because he invented at that time when there was not very much things had happened in English literature. During that time, Geoffrey Chaucer had given English literature a very unique stanza form that is known as Rhyme Royal, and it has 7 lines in each stanza. Next, we have Geoffrey married Philippa Roet in 1366. She was the daughter of Sir Piney Roet. Yes, Geoffrey Chaucer का जो मैरिज हुआ था वो 1366 में हुआ था फिलिपा रॉयट से, एंड शी वॉज इन्फ्लुएंशियल लेडी बिकॉज हर फैमिली वॉज वेरी मच इन्फ्लुएंशियल, वेरी मच वेल्दी, एंड दैट्स वाई देर वॉज अ सम नाइस थिंग्स हैड हैपेंड विद जोफ्री चौसर, एंड ऑन द यू कैन से दैट फाइनेंशियली कंडीशन वॉज ऑफ जोफ्री चौसर वॉज नाउ बिकेम साउंड आफ्टर ही got married with Philippa Roet in 1366. Next fact we have about Geoffrey Chaucer. In 1368, Geoffrey Chaucer became one of King Edward III's squires. Squires यहाँ पे मतलब knighthood का होता है, knight होते हैं जो king के सर्विस में होते हैं, और 1368 में Geoffrey Chaucer became one of the king's knighthood that was of King Edward III ke jo the. His position sent him on diplomatic missions. Yes, because of this position he was sent by the king to the diplomatic missions to different countries, and this gave him a chance to familiarize with the literature of the world that was, you know, like Petrarch and Dante's, such great poets, such great writers, such great poets, where he was very much influenced with this literature of the world, like Petrarch and Dante, because of the missions, because of the diplomatic missions he had served for the King Edward III. Next we have, it is believed that Geoffrey Chaucer's Parliament of Fowls, yes, this is a poetic composition of Geoffrey Chaucer, was written in 1380. It was a poem about courtly love. Yes, friends, ये courtly love के ऊपर poem based on है, जो कि प्रॉक्स लिखी गई थी 1380 के आसपास. That is, the poem name is Parliament of Fowls, and it has the theme, it has the main point, which main theme, and you can say the what is the form of the poetry it has, that was related to the courtly love, because Geoffrey Chaucer had spent much time in court in the service of the king. That's why he had came with this creation, with this poetic composition, that is Parliament of Fowls, and it has a subject matter of courtly love. Next we have, it is believed that Geoffrey Chaucer wrote Troilus and Cressida in the mid 1380s, a poem about his character's tragic love story, and this poem is considered by many to be the his greatest work. Yes, Troilus and Cressida, which was published about the mid of the 1830 के आसपास ये बुक लिखी गई थी, बुक कंपोज की गई थी ये पोएम, और ये एक ट्रेजिक लव स्टोरी पे बेस्ड ऑन है जो सब्जेक्ट मैटर है इस पोटी कॉम्पोजिशन का ऑफ जियोफ्री चौसर, एंड इट इज कंसिडर्ड एज वन ऑफ द बेस्ट poetic composition or composition of Geoffrey Chaucer. Now let's move on to the discuss some few more facts about Geoffrey Chaucer. Next we have, Geoffrey Chaucer's work The Canterbury Tales was originally meant to be 120 stories long. It was only completed 224 stories, and his characters did not make it to the Canterbury at all. The work was never finished, but it is highly regarded in literature. Yes, friends, The Canterbury Tales, which was a poetic composition of Geoffrey Chaucer, and it is regarded magnum opus of Geoffrey Chaucer. Bahut hi important book hai, bahut hi, you can say this is the one of the best book of English literature written by Geoffrey Chaucer, composed by Geoffrey Chaucer. It has a in a poetic form, and Chaucer has decided to write 120 stories because there were 30 pilgrims, and each has to tell 4 stories during them when they were going to the shrine of the Sir Thomas Becket, and but unfortunately, only 25 stories had completed, and all the character couldn't find allowed to tell a story, because and it was not completed at all. It was never finished by Geoffrey Chaucer, but even it was in fragment, ye fragment mein thi, but it is regarded as one of the best book, one of the famous book, famous poetic composition of Geoffrey Chaucer and also of English literature. Next we have Geoffrey Chaucer's major work include Roman de la Rose. Yes, this is one of the composition of the Geoffrey Chaucer, the Book of the Duchess, the House of Fame, Annelida and Arcite, Parliament of Fowls, Bouche, Troilus and Cressida, The Legend of Good Women, The Canterbury Tales, and A Treatise on the Astrobel. These are the important work and major work of Geoffrey Chaucer. So friends, आज जो हमने discuss किया कुछ important facts उनके literary career and life से related discuss किए हैं इस video में. And friends, एक important चीज मैं आप सबको बता दूं that I have now decided कि आपके लिए मैं कुछ notes available कराऊंगी यहाँ पे इस वीडियो यहाँ पे इस चैनल पे, बट वो उन्हीं के लिए अवेलेबल होगी जो इस चैनल के मेंबरशिप को ज्वाइन करेंगे, क्योंकि नोट्स वहाँ पे क्वेश्चंस आंसर्स होंगे उसके, शॉर्ट क्वेश्चंस लॉन्ग आंसर्स होंगे, बिकॉज जो आप अपने यूजी अगर आप एग्जाम्स देते हो, जैसे आप अपने ग्रेजुएशन लेवल के एग्जाम्स या पीजी लेवल के एग्जाम्स के लिए आपका जो सेमेस्टर वाइज एग्जाम होता है उसके लिए बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट वो नोट्स अवेलेबल होंगे, और वो उसी पे बेस्ड ऑन होंगे जो कि आपके सिलेबस से रिलेटेड होंगे. मैं ट्राई करूंगी उन क्वेश्चंस को आपके पास ले आने की दैट वर इन द नोट्स फॉर्म, वो पीडीएफ में अवेलेबल होंगे आपको, उसको वर्ड की फाइल में अवेलेबल होंगे, आप उनको इस चैनल से या रिक्वेस्ट करके आप इस पे से ले सकते हो. बट दैट इज फॉर द मेंबर्स हु विल ज्वाइन द मेंबरशिप ऑफ दिस चैनल ऑफ इंग्लैंड जोन. एंड फ्रेंड्स, यस, आगे आने वाले डेज में मैं और ही इंपॉर्टेंट वीडियोज आपके लिए लेके आऊंगी. टिल देन कीप कनेक्टिंग इंग्लिश जोन एंड थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर वॉचिंग दिस.